Hello students, today we are going to start the class with a small activity. See, what am I doing? Watering the flower pots. You might also have done this at home. If you have flower pots, you need to water it regularly. What is it called? It's called irrigation. So, what is irrigation? Irrigation is the process of supplying water to the land at regular intervals. So, why do we need to irrigate the land or water the land? Water is important for proper growth and development of flowers, fruits, and seeds of plants. Water is absorbed by the plant roots. Along with water, minerals and fertilizers are also absorbed. Plants contain nearly 90% water. Water is essential because germination of seeds does not take place under dry conditions. Nutrients dissolved in water get transported to each part of the plant. Water also protects the crop from both frost and hot air currents. So, to maintain the moisture of the soil for healthy crop growth, we need to water the land regularly. So, the supply of water to crops at different intervals is called irrigation. We have been discussing crop production management. The other day, we discussed about nutrient management. Today, and nutrient management, that is by adding manure and fertilizer to the soil, we add the nutrients. Plant roots absorb the nutrients along with water. 13 nutrients they get it from the soil. Rest of this they get it from the air and water. The time and frequency of irrigation varies from crop to crop, soil to soil, and season to season. That means, so time to time we need to water the land. Most agriculture in India is rain-fed. That is, the success of crops in most areas is dependent on timely monsoons and sufficient rainfall spread through most of the growing season. That means, if timely monsoon and sufficient rainfall can give us expected yield. But poor monsoons cause crop failure. So, ensuring that crops get water at right stages during their growing season can increase the expected yields of any crop. Therefore, many measures are used to bring more and more agricultural land under irrigation. India has a variety of water resources and a highly varied climate. Under such conditions, several different kinds of irrigation systems are adopted to supply water to agricultural lands depending on the kinds of water resources available. That means there must be a source of water from where the water is taken to the field. So it may be the sources, it may be wells, canals, river or tanks or reservoirs. So from this is the source of water. So whichever is available in that place, from there the water has to be taken to the land. What we say assured irrigation, that is the farmers does not depend only on rainwater. Rather, there is a source of water from where water is taken to the field so that regularly when it is needed, water can be supplied to the plants. Let us discuss about how it is done. Here I show you some pictures. These are some traditional methods of irrigation. First, wells. There are two types of wells, namely dug wells and tube wells. In dug well, water is collected from water bearing strata. Strata means layer. Tube wells can tap water from deeper strata or from the deeper layer. So water can be lifted up manually or by the help of animals also it can be lifted up. Or the pumps also can be used for lifting up water from these wells. And it is being supplied to the field. Other is canals. This is usually an elaborate and extensive irrigation system. In this system, canals receive water from one or more reservoirs or from rivers. So here the source of water is a reservoir, water reservoir or the river, from where it is being collected, and the canals or this channels which are being made. The main canal is divided into branches. The main canal is divided into branch canals having further distributaries to irrigate fields. So there is a, as if a pipeline is there. So the canals which are being made, so it is connected to the reservoir or river from where water is drawn. Next is river lift systems. In areas where canal flow is insufficient or irregular due to inadequate reservoir release, the lift system is more rational. So here directly from river it is sent to the field. Actually it is possible if the fields which are nearby. So water is directly drawn from the rivers for supplementing irrigation in areas close to rivers. Next is tanks. Tanks, these are small storage reservoirs. So these are also the water reservoirs which intercept and store the runoff of small catchment areas. That is, some water get collected here, the rainwater actually it is being collected and it is supplied to the field from these reservoirs. Fresh initiatives for increasing the water available for agriculture include rainwater harvesting and watershed management. These are the practices nowadays it is being adopted. What is rainwater harvesting? That is, rainwater get collected in a place. So this involves building small check dams. So the small check dams which collect the rainwater for a period of time, as it is getting collected in a place for a period of time, it will percolate down, which will recharge the groundwater. The check dams stop the rainwater from flowing away and also reduce soil erosion. Here I show you two modern methods of irrigation: drip system and sprinkler system. Sprinkler system is more useful on the uneven land where sufficient water is not available. Water gets sprinkled on the crop as if it is raining. Sprinkler is very useful for sandy soil. Whereas in drip system, the water falls drop by drop just at the position of the roots. Here, water is not wasted at all. It is a boon in regions where availability of water is poor. So, where there is water available, so from that source, we take this to the field. In some cases, the water is poorly available or sufficient amount of water is not available, so these systems can give a better result. But a condition, say about where there is scarcity or irregular distribution of rains. So a condition arises that is called drought. Drought poses a threat to rain-fed farming areas where farmers do not use irrigation for crop production and depend only on rain. Light soils have less water retention capacity. In areas with light soils, crops get adversely affected by drought conditions. Scientists have developed some crop varieties which can tolerate drought conditions. So, in the places where irregular distribution of rain and the farmers do not use any irrigation practices, so there these drought resistant varieties can give a better yield. So today we have discussed irrigation. Thank you, students.